reading, and look at where we got already. We got our buttresses going on. We got our fireplace in the background over there in the corner, that little beautiful circle connecting to our bedroom dorm. Access from here. We have our little shower bump out here, which has its, basically acts like a doorway. We create the buttress, but the shower itself is the buttress. And then we create an opening with a little header on there. And then we have this really interesting little shower. We're gonna put colored glass all around and as it goes up. So you get this, also showered by sunshine and light coming in. We've connected, we put up our forms for our doors. We've got our compasses, everything's in now. We did miss a little bit on getting some of the buttresses in early, but because a lot of this is actually under the ground, the first two layers is going to be covered, and we're pretty secure. So just to give you, everybody went home and we've just been messing around, checking some things and make and do with materials that we have rather than buying. So a lot of the forms for these, because they're going to have a header above it, a beam, and we don't necessarily need to make a solid form and with an arch top like we're doing on the other two doors. So these were just propping up something that we can bag up against. So you can be creative with that part, I think, as long as it's sturdy. And as long as you get your angle and everything right, and you've got enough surface to bag up against, then whatever's, you know, most economic really for you. If you can use scraps of material on the side for your forms, this is much better than, you know, buying premium plywood. Ask Genghis, he's been paying for all these things. So we got a plastic covering our first couple of bags, and now we're over the top of that, so that plastic on the inside we're not as worried about it because we're going to plaster the walls and we don't really want to plaster the plastic on the inside. And then we're going to bring up gravel here and put the earthen floor in here, and that will have all plastic sealed underneath as well, so any moisture is not really going to be an issue here. Yeah, it's just really nice today that we connected the two. We started lifting and connecting these two together, which was really important because it started to see exactly how these pieces are interrelating. And then with the fireplace, we connected it in here as the buttress also. So use your buttresses creatively. This buttress here is going to come, and then we're going to extend it a little bit with a countertop for like a peninsula. So, you know, get creative with buttresses, because they are one thing about super adobe that seemed to kind of get in the way a little bit. So just try and find creative ways to use them. This was obviously quite a creative moment. And then we'll have a big opening here, which we'll build a form for that very soon. Another form. And then there'll be a fireplace in here with fire brick separating these, the outside fire and the inside fire. And then that's bedroom, living room. This, we're having to step up into this space, so quite easy to see the difference between this level, which will go, this will be our interior floor level, a little bit above here. So we're going to have gravel and then have a layered earthen floor. So this one will have a step up into this space, just as a little, make an interesting effect. Yeah, we'll come back tomorrow and keep moving up. I think the next important thing to show is really about the window forms and putting them things in, how to work with that. But we'll break things down into more lessons. The other thing that we're using that you don't have to use, but we cut 50 pieces of 40 centimeter rebar, and we're using it on the corners and on the joints of buttresses. Where we feel are necessary, like at the door, at the shower, and you don't have to use these every time you're bagging every three layers, but I'd like to use them intermittently just as an extra support. Like I think as we move up, then we'll put some in the buttress here. So then you're also connecting the buttress in all together. It's just extra things. I don't think you need to, but my background, I think it's best to be safe for the sake of how much does it cost for, like, 4 or 5 pieces of rebar, you know, $30 or something like that, I think. But it's a really good measure. The thing is, with the rebar, you have to put it in the day that you're bagging, because once it's the next day, it's too hard, and if you try to hammer through that rebar, you're going to crack open your already solidified earth. So don't do that unless you want to drill through with a big drill bit. Do it the day you're building, and then you can hammer through them layers and it'll go in no problem, and then the next day it'll be fixed in there. And then you can start bagging on top of that. Apart from that, everything's as usual. We're loving the 40 bags. They're much better to work with, actually. It works faster, it's a thicker layer, and I don't think anyone's really complained about the weight of it. You can stand on it a lot easier as you move up. So I would definitely use 40s as a general rule from now on. We are using 30s on the shower. We just wanted to, it's a tight curve. It's the tightest curve we got, and I think it would be too tight for the 40. So that maybe is one restriction. This is a little bigger in the fireplace, which was already too a little tight, but we managed it. So for the shower, it would have been too tight. So when you get to smaller circles, you can go to the 30 bag, and then the only issue is the thickness, but you can always put some plywood in between the layer, fix a piece of screw, a piece of plywood in to give you that little extra. So when this one comes, the next one can go on top. And that's about it for lessons today. I took a few little lessons, and tomorrow we'll go through as we move up and putting the windows in. But I think that's about it for today.